Hey guys, welcome to my channel. So for today's video, I'm going to be doing a glam back to school makeup tutorial. Obviously this is kind of a lot. I'm wearing fake eyelashes, a full face of foundation, concealer, things like that. But this is just for those types of girls that like to do it. It's still not too much, but it's still pretty glam. It really opened up my face. I will also be uploading like my 10 minute back to school makeup routine, which is like nothing compared to this. But I mean, there's two types of girls, and I hope you guys enjoy this tutorial, so just keep watching. So it's been a while since I've just kind of done my makeup and like talked and stuff, because I've been doing a lot of reviews. So I just thought I would take a break from that and do this tutorial for you guys. So we're gonna start off with the skin. Most of the makeup in this look is going to be drugstore, except for a few things like this, the Smashbox Photo Finish Primerizer. This is just so good, and you need it. If you have dry skin, you know, really moisturizes it. And you know, this is the first layer on your face. I always think it's good to spend a little extra money on what's going on your skin, you know? Okay, so like I said, this is not about to be one of those natural 10 minute back to school tutorials. This is for people that are like extra like I was and don't mind wearing a full face of makeup. So I'm using the Loreal Infallible Pro Matte Foundation. This is good because it lasts a really long time on the skin. I don't know, I just think it's generally a very good drugstore foundation. Pretty decent coverage too, but it's still very comfortable on the skin because you are going to wear it for a long time during a school day. It's a little light on me right now. I've been out in the sun a lot lately for my job, and none of my foundations match me. This also oxidizes a little bit, so it'll look better in a second. If it's not your color, blend it into your hairline. Okay, so now I like to go into my eyebrows. I think an eyebrow pencil is your best bet for school anyways. I'm going to use the Anastasia Brow Wiz in the shade medium brown. Again, something I couldn't compromise on just because I don't own any drugstore brow pencils, because this is just the only one I use. I do have a separate eyebrow tutorial coming eventually. I filmed it a while ago, but I'm just looking for that perfect time to post it when I need to post something, but I don't have time, because in the next few coming weeks I'm gonna be super duper busy. Like, I'm talking 12-hour days, and I'm not gonna have any time to make videos, unfortunately. So I'm hoping that's when I'll use the weekends to make videos or something. I don't know, we'll see how it goes. But fair warning, I'm about to be super duper busy. I'm of course going to try to keep my posting schedule at least 2 videos a week, but I don't know how successful I can be in that, because this is like a pivotal time in my education and just like leading me up to getting a job. My eyebrows aren't in their best place right now also, so let it be. So recently I've fallen in love with a new eyebrow product. This is the Colourpop Brow Wash Gel. I really like it because I just feel like it makes my eyebrows look genuinely thicker. I think it's supposed to mimic like the soap brow, soap trend, where you would like brush a spoolie against soap. It like thickens the look of your eyebrows, and I honestly think that this does that. It's a little annoying because it has like that gunky white stuff. Like, I don't know if you can see it, but it kind of just goes away, and it just really, look how bushy it's making my eyebrows look. I'm gonna comb it down because I don't like them to look that bushy. So I kind of just wait for it to dry, and then I like wipe it a little bit and the white stuff just goes away. So I've been really enjoying this product, and it's only like $6 too. All right, so I'm gonna take a little bit of concealer just to clean up under my brow. I mean, if you don't have time to do this, you don't have to. But this is probably more of like the first day of school kind of makeup tutorial, and then you never try ever again for the rest of the year, unless you're Morgan Turner and wore a full face of makeup every day in high school. By the way, I'm using the Maybelline Fit Me concealer. I will link down my shade in the description box. But this is the best concealer, not even just drugstore wise, but literally the only concealer I use, basically. If I have time, I'm definitely going to be posting a 10-minute back to school tutorial. Just because I do have that, that's the look I'll probably be wearing when I go back to school. Oh yeah, by the way, I'm going back to school, but this time, I mean, I'm still a student. I know I graduated college, but I actually graduated college with one major, and I still have to finish my second major, but I feel like I'm not in college anymore because I'm not living at my college anymore. I'm living at home to finish, and I'm student teaching. So I'm actually going to be back in an elementary school. So I am technically really going back to school. And that's when I'll do my 10-minute makeup tutorial for you guys to show you the makeup that I do in like 10 minutes. Because I'm doing PE, so there's no need for me to wear this full face, you know? Now I'm gonna use, again, one of my favorite powders of all time. This Maybelline Fit Me line, man. I love it. I'm gonna use the Fair Light powder. I'm gonna use that to set my under eye. And then also in the areas that crease a lot. And then kind of whatever is left over on my brush, I'm gonna pat it everywhere else. I do have dry skin. If you do have oily skin, of course, go in with more powder. So to bronze up my skin, I'm using the Morphe Bronzer in the shade Celebutante. I've really been enjoying this a lot, and I'm kind of just gonna focus my brush mainly on this side and then dabble a little bit into the dark side. But not too much. And if you weren't talking as much as I am, you actually could get this makeup look done relatively fast, just because the techniques I'm using are very simple and quick, but they still create a really nice effect where it looks like you spent more time. I'm not gonna worry about contouring, just that bronzing right there. And then for blush, you always need a little bit of blush so that you can look awake. I'm gonna use this blush that has a little bit of a sheen in it. This is by Flower Beauty. This is the blush Warm Hibiscus. Really gorgeous. Lately, I haven't been into blushes with a gold shift to them. I think they just kind of emphasize texture that I don't want emphasized. But just a little bit is fine, especially when you're not putting too much highlighter on. But yeah, these pink with gold shift blushes haven't been my jam lately. I don't know why, because I used to love them. And I am going to apply a little bit of highlighter though. This is the Wet n Wild highlighter in the shade Earth. This is from their new Zodiac collection. I did buy basically that entire collection except for all of the lip stuff, and honestly I was a little disappointed in it. But I do really like this highlight in particular. I really think it stands out in the collection. It's really something. All right, and now let's move on to eyes. I'm actually going to use the new ColourPop palette, the Zodiac, that was a collaboration with KathleenLights, because everybody loves KathleenLights, including me. And you can actually get a really pretty glam neutral look with this, despite all the colors being in here. So I'm going to start off with the shade Taurus, and that's gonna go all over the crease. Now this is a glam look, but it's still a back to school look, so I'm keeping the colors very neutral. And honestly, you cannot go wrong with ColourPop shadows. Not only are they affordable, but they're super good. While you're at it, with a smaller brush, I'm just gonna run that along my lower lash line as well. I'm then gonna go in with a touch of Virgo right here, which is a deeper brown on a slightly smaller crease brush. And I'm just gonna kind of pop that right in the outer corner, not too much product. And this is just going to create a little bit of depth in the eye, but nothing too crazy. You don't want too much. We are still going to school. I also bought the whole collection of this Zodiac line, and I love it. I don't know if I love it or if I love it because it's Kathleen, but I love it. And on the lid, I'm going to put the Gemini, which is this gorgeous, gorgeous gold color right here. This is really gonna make your eyes pop. So I love how like colorful this palette is, but how you can still get these pretty everyday neutral looks, you know? I'm gonna go back in with the Wet n Wild highlighter, and I'm just gonna put a little bit under my brow. Again, this is being extra. If you don't have time, you don't have to do this, but these little details make a big difference in the big picture, you know? I need to do a video of my recent favorites because I've just got so much makeup and I've tried so much new makeup and I just haven't gotten a chance to talk about it. All right, so to finish up the eyes, you don't have to do eyeliner. I don't know, when I was growing up in high school and even middle school, things like that, eyeliner was a big thing. Like, you always wore eyeliner. I've been so lazy recently. I haven't been wearing eyeliner. I'm like, it's a glam look, but it's still back to school. I'm just gonna skip the liner. I'm gonna go straight into curling my eyelashes. Because eyeliner just takes too much time. I'm sorry. If you're going to school, you're up way too early anyways. You don't need to be wasting time on eyeliner. So I'm just going to take the tiniest bit of mascara. So I'm going to wipe off most of the stuff on the brush. And I'm just going to focus it on the ends of my lashes to really build it up. I don't know, I have weird eyelashes and this looks the best. My eyelashes are so short that the only way for them to be noticed is to focus on the ends to lengthen them and not even worry about volume. I'm just going to take a tiny bit to my lower lashes as well. This is one of the things where if you do it, it makes you look like you put a lot more effort than you did. I'm just saying, this look took me a pretty quick time to do. I'm on 20 minutes, but I've been talking the entire time, not just ripping out the makeup. Again, if you want to be super glam, put on some lashes. I would prefer some lashes over liner, but it's all personal preference. I just think lashes is one of those things where if you're feeling tired, it's going to just kind of make you look awake, but it is kind of hard to maintain throughout the school day. But I'm gonna do it because this is a glam back to school look. So I'm going to use some good old Ardell Demi Wispies. Get them in a 5-pack. Do yourself a favor. You can grab them at the drugstore, at Walmart. And these lashes look pretty on everybody and they're not too crazy. If you're not sure what lash to pick up, definitely try the Ardell Wispies or Demi Wispies. If you're scared of lashes, try Demi Wispies. If you're not, try regular Wispies. See, for me, I'm such like a lash lover and I've become such an expert at putting them on that I don't mind putting them on for every day because they don't even take that long. They're definitely less time to put on than liner and I prefer lashes to liner anyways, you know? Oh my goodness. So yeah, that was the right decision. So for lips, what I'm going to use is the Colourpop lipstick in Scorpio Moon. This is also from the KathleenLights collection and it's so pretty. It's like a purpley mauve. Alright, so I mean that completes this look. It actually was a lot quicker to do than it looks. This only took me like 20 minutes and I'm wearing lashes and a full face of like base products and everything. So really, really good for school and it really opens up your face, makes you look really pretty. You don't look like you tried too hard, but you still look good. You know, you're still looking glam, things like that. This would also be really, really good for picture day. Anyways, I'm gonna shut up now. I hope you guys enjoyed this tutorial. Remember to subscribe to my channel, like this video, this, that, and the other. I will see you guys in the next video. Bye.